things could get interesting in the forecast tomorrow, especially on Thursday because of something going on in the Gulf of Mexico. Today, though, no impacts from that potential tropical storm. Just hot all over again. Even hotter than yesterday, in fact, because we don't have any of those light showers around. Howdy Honda looks nice with a bit of a breeze from the north and northeast. 91 degrees already, and here we go. 96 this afternoon up in Georgetown and Lockhart. 97s on the thermometer today from Austin down to Bastrop. And again, partly cloudy skies, no rain is in the forecast. Couple different things actually in our tropical update here. The first one is a very unusually positioned June tropical storm named Brett. Here it is, churning its way through the Caribbean Sea toward the west. It's not going to impact us at all. We're actually expecting it to fall apart entirely because the atmosphere out there just trying to rip it apart by tomorrow night. So we'll keep you posted. Here's the one that we really are watching very, very carefully. This red X denotes the center of a weak, disorganized tropical wave. Let's call it a tropical disturbance. The National Hurricane Center is saying this thing is actually already at tropical storm strength with winds sustained at 40, gusting to 50 miles an hour. It's just not quite organized enough to label it Tropical Storm Cindy. We do expect it to become Cindy, though, really any time. Next advisory when that might happen is 1 p.m. today. We'll let you know right here. We do expect a track toward the Texas or Louisiana coast. These solid lines toward Louisiana, those are tropical storm warnings, and they do include parts of East Texas now. This not solid line, the outline there, that's a tropical storm watch, which now actually includes the city of Houston. By Thursday at 7 a.m., this could be the position spinning inland from northward of the Galveston, Beaumont area, up the coast, or up the border, rather, of Texas and Louisiana. The big question is, this track keeps shifting a little bit farther west with every advisory from the Hurricane Center, and every little shift to the west makes rain right here a little bit more likely. So even though that track is still pretty far away from us, and that would put us on the drier west side, doesn't mean we're out of the woods yet. This is another reliable hurricane model, and it actually puts some rain into our area, maybe along and east of 35, during the day on Thursday, before the storm gets out of here. Model number two, which is one I was showing you this morning, it's starting to back off of how optimistic it was about our rain chances, but it still spins the storm toward Houston, possibly a little rain here tomorrow evening, and then, according to this model, possibly some heavy rain here at times Thursday morning, Thursday evening, before that storm gets out of here on Friday morning. So I know that those are three pretty drastically different scenarios. The bottom line is we are not certain on the track until this thing gets its act together, until it forms. So as that happens, probably through the afternoon and evening today, we're going to get a lot more confidence in how this plays out. Rain, though, is now possible in your local forecast late tomorrow and especially on Thursday. Remember, this is the same storm we told you about on the weather blog here 8 days ago, and now it has finally formed. You can use this tropical tracker tool. Very cool to see the watches, the warnings, and every different computer model forecast. This is always available for you and the kids to check out, KXAN.com. So no rain, no impacts today, just hot and dry. But on the first day of summer tomorrow into Thursday, we will be watching that storm very, very closely. Now, regardless of what that plays out through the next several days, a rare late June cold front is coming in this weekend. Relatively mild temperatures and some scattered rain Saturday and Sunday.